Hey everyone, in this After Effects tutorial, we will create this burning text effect animation in After Effects without using any plugins. And if you enjoy watching advanced title or text animation tutorials, I have a complete playlist ready for you with over 100 plus free tutorials that you can watch right now. Link is in the description. With that said, let's jump straight into After Effects and get started. Now before we start this video, I just want to take a moment and tell you guys about my Motion Designers Bundle, which consists of 3 huge animation packs for After Effects, completely designed and animated by me, so all the animations are super high quality and easy to customize and use. For more info, check out the first link in the description below. Alright guys, so here we are in After Effects. Let's start by creating a new composition. Call this render as our main render comp. 2560x1440, 30fps and 10 seconds long duration. Let's select the text tool and type in whatever text that you want. You can also use a logo if you want to. So I'm going to type in Blades of Fire. There we go. And for the font, I'm using Dharma Gothic. Feel free to use any font that you like. Also, pretty quickly, I'm going to go into Effects and Presets and add a gradient ramp just to make it look a bit more interesting instead of keeping it just blank white. Not gradient wipe, gradient ramp. All right, swap the colors and I'll pull this one right here. And this is looking quite nice. All right, let's also add a background. So I'll press Ctrl Y to create a new solid. Call this BG for background with a black color. Press OK. And then we can select both of these layers. Make sure the background is at the back. Select them, press Ctrl Shift C to pre-compose it. And I'm going to call this title. Move all attributes and press OK. That is fine. Let's create another new composition. This is going to be our burn map. So I'm going to type in burn map. Press OK. Then press Ctrl Y to create a new solid. Call this burn and press OK. And then go into Effects and Presets and search for an effect called CC Burn Film. Apply that and let's animate this. So at the very start, I'll create a new keyframe on the burn, which is set to 0, and I'll go to around 6 seconds and set this all the way up to 100. Also make sure the layer is white. So I'll select this, go into the layer solid settings and make it white. Press OK. Then go into Effects and Presets, search for solid composite and make it black. So now we have this nice matte transition, which will be super useful. I'm going to scale this up a little bit. So press S and scale this up by around 200. All right. Okay. Now let's add some texture to this. So I'll create a new solid. Press Ctrl Y again. Let's rename this to fractal. Press OK. Go into Effects and Presets. Search for fractal noise. Double click to apply that. Let's go into the transform properties and scale this up by 200 and change the blend mode of this to overlay. So now we have something like this. Pretty cool. Now let's go into our main project panel and drag the title composition on top. Change the blend mode of this to overlay as well. So now we have something that looks like this. Go into effects and presets, search for Gaussian blur. Double click and set this to 40. Then go into effects and presets again, search for hue and saturation, double click to apply that. And what I'm going to do is bring down the master saturation all the way up to -100. Now what I'm going to do is select the burn layer that we had and let's move this a little to the bottom left so that it starts from right here, and that is looking quite nice, I think. All right, I think the fractal texture is a bit too harsh, so I'm going to select this, press T to bring down the opacity and bring that down to around 30. So that looks much better, I think. Yep. Now right click and create a new adjustment layer. Let's call this bright. Select it, go into effects and presets, search for brightness and contrast, double click to apply that, set the contrast to 99. And make sure to turn on use legacy. So this will give us this little nice and crispy looking matte transition. Pretty cool. You can always play around with the burn seed. So let's say if I set it something like 10, we have a different way it animates, and that is what I'm looking for. So you can always play around with the random seed, so you will get different instances of the animation. Now let's start building up our burning scene. So let's call this burn scene. Press Ctrl Y to create a new solid, make this black, and call this BG for background. Add the title composition on top. So there we go. And on top of that, I'm going to add the burn map. Okay. Select the title composition. Go into effects and presets, search for set matte effect. Double click to apply that. Set this to burn map and set the use from matte to luminance. Then go into effects and presets again, search for brightness and contrast effect. Set the brightness to around 45. And then finally, I'll add a tint effect and make it completely black. Now let's select the burn map layer and press Ctrl D to duplicate it. Go into effects and presets, search for fast box blur. Double click to apply that, and let's set the blur radius to around 28. Then search for levels effect and let's add that. Now we need to extract the sharpness back. So I'm going to drag this slider like so. Then search for hue and saturation effect. Turn on colorize and set this one to around 30. And the saturation, I'll set this to 15 and lightness to 15 as well. And then finally, I will search for the set matte effect. Double click to apply that and set this to burn map layer and this one to luminance. There you go. So now we have something like this. Let's duplicate this burn map again. Press Ctrl D and we can press Ctrl A and delete all the effects on this one. We can also change the color of this to something different like yellow. Go into effects and presets, search for an effect called invert, double click to apply that, and then search for turbulent displace. Let's set this to around 40 and the size to something like 25 should be fine. Then I'll add a CC composite effect and set the transfer mode to multiply. So now we have this nice edges. This will help us to add more detail into the transition, the burning effect. Then go into effects and presets again, search for fractal noise. Set the contrast to 200 and the brightness to minus 25. Then let's add a Triton effect to add some nice color to this. For this one, I'm going to go with a nice light yellow. And this one will be a bit more intense blue. And then we can add some nice glow as well. I'll increase the radius to around 50, should be fine. And then I'll add a set matte effect. Select the burn map again and set this to luminance. All right, and then change the blend mode of this to add. In the burn map, we also need to select the fractal noise and change the blend mode of this to multiply so that the fractal noise only affects the edges. So now we have the edges. Now we need to work a little bit more on the fogginess, the smokiness that the fire creates. Also, I want to increase the glow. So I'll increase the intensity of the glow first of all to around 3. So it's a bit more intense as you can see. Yep. So now let's add some nice fogginess to this. So I can duplicate this blur map, press Ctrl D, and we can change the color, or we can even call this fog map or something like that. But yeah, color change is fine for now. Also, the blending mode of this, I'll change this to screen, and then I can select Ctrl A to select all the effects and delete them. Go into effects and presets and search for an effect called CC wide time. Apply that. Let's set the forward steps to 0 and the backward steps to around 20 should be fine. So this will just displace this a little bit more. Then go into effects and presets, search for set matte effect. Set this to title. Select the set matte and duplicate this and change this one to burn map and use matte from luminance. Also, I'm going to invert the matte. As you can see, it looks a bit choppy. So let's add some nice fast box blur on this. And I'll set this to around somewhere around 10 should be fine. Then I will add a solid composite and make it black. And then I'll add a fractal noise to add some more texture to this. Make sure you change the blend mode of the fractal noise to multiply. Yep. So now you can see we have that nice smokiness around the fire. Let's polish this a little bit more. Let's also add a turbulent displace and bring down the size to 30, should be fine. And I think I'll set this to twist. That looks much better. And let's select this press T and bring down the opacity to 50. So now you can see we have a little bit more detail and this fogginess around the fire, which makes it look much more interesting. See right here. Pretty nice. And finally, I will add some fractals of fire around the edges to make it look even more interesting and sell out the complete effect. So I'll duplicate the blur map, press Ctrl D. I'll delete the set mat for now. I'll bring up the solid composite effect and also increase the backward steps to 60. Get rid of the fast box blur, we don't need it. And fractal noise, I'll play around a little bit with the settings. So I'll increase the contrast to 250 and bring down the brightness to minus 80 should be fine. I can also animate the evolution, so I can add a very simple expression on this. So hold Alt, click on the evolution stopwatch. Let's type in time times 50. And then I'll add a set mat effect. Set this one to title. Duplicate this and set this one to burn map and this one to luminance. And invert it. All right, let's add the Triton color again. So it should be right here. Press Ctrl C and the glow as well. So press Ctrl C, Ctrl V. So there we go. And I'll make this a bit more yellow in tone. Now, because I'm stacking up so many different effects, sometimes I forget to add one or two. So I forgot to add a brightness and contrast in this one. So let's quickly add that. And I'll place it below the fractal noise. Let's increase the contrast all the way up to 100. And make sure to turn on use legacy. So now we should have a little bit fractals happening here and there, which are very minute for now. So I can play around a little bit with the fractals. So I can bring those up. So you can see this. And also for the color, I'll go with a nice intense orange. So there we go, looking pretty nice. We can also play around with the complexity a little bit, I think. And always you can go back to the burn map layer and play around with the seed. So let's change it. Until we get something that we like. I think that looks much better. Let's go back. Okay. Now we can start building up our main scene. So I'll go into our main project panel and go back into our main render composition. And let's delete this for now. Let's start from scratch. So let's type in, Control Y to create a new background, call this BG. On top of this, I'll add the burn map composition and hide that because we need to use it as a track mat for later on. Let's add the title composition and I'll zoom into my timeline, go to around 20 frames and push this back in time. I'll also push the burn map right here, right click, go into time and enable time remapping and stretch this out like so. Then let's add the burn scene on top and I'll place it at around 10 frames. Then go into effects and presets, search for set mat effect. Apply that and select the burn map and luminance. And set this one to effects and mask. So now we have this kind of a nice reveal. You can always play around with this depending on the intensity of the edges that you want. You can see we get this really nice look. I think this is fine. And make sure the background is white instead of black. So I can simply add a fill effect. So you can see we have this nice details into the text. looking pretty nice. Now what we can do is go into the project panel, and here we have the burn scene. Let's duplicate this, press Ctrl D and rename this to flakes. Open that composition and let's hide the background and these two composition. We only need the flakes right here. Okay, there we go. And let's go back into our main render composition, drag them on the top. Let's position them like so and set this to screen, I think. So now we have some nice intense flakes. I can bring down the opacity obviously if I want to, but I think I'll also hide the smoke layer. We only want the flakes. And we can always play around with this. So there we go, looking pretty good. Okay, so that is looking pretty nice. And remember, you can always change the random seed and make it look completely different, make it appear, I mean, completely differently. So I can anytime go into the burn map and just go right here into the burn layer and play around with the random seed. So let's set this something to 18. I don't know why. And there we have a different reveal. There you go. And there we have our fiery burning style title animation inside of After Effects that we created without using any plugin. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. If you did, do let me know in the comments below, and I have a complete playlist dedicated to title animation, some really advanced title animation that you should definitely check them out. Again, all the links are in the description. With that said, I will see you guys in the next video. Till then, take care and always stay raw, stay creative. Peace out.